Welcome or welcome back to the channel. Today, the penultimate episode for Season 5 of Better Call Saul. This is Episode 9, Bad Choice Road. Which I'm guessing this is Jimmy just continuing to make bad decisions following, you know, however him and Mike are surviving, you know, this bag run through the desert. Yeah, I know there was a lot of missed opportunity last episode for Dune jokes and references, but trust me, they will be on the episode of The Witcher, because that was a lot more isolation and desert harshness than I would say, you know, this Better Call Saul was previously. I've been working in DC a lot this week, and there's this one area we drive through in Silver Spring to get into DC. It's a large Hispanic population, and, you know, I saw abogado on a building. I was like, abogado! ¿Cómo se dice lawyer en español? Abogado. So the last video had a comment posted on it, and I used that opportunity to shit on myself, you know, self-deprecating as I am. Conversation back and forth. It's not really a pity party. I'm just trying to illustrate to you that what you see on the screen, you know, when you watch someone, is generally the best block of time that they're giving you. It's either the best mood, the best performance, the most energy, but this does not represent, like, the hour that I watch this, you know, in the 20 minutes you see, does not represent, you know, me in the other 23 hours of the day. So, I'm just saying, don't prop people up, don't trust the internet, don't trust when people give you a highlight reel or can cut together things, because, you know, they can make things appear different ways, that's all. Just, that's all. Just a bullshit susceptibility check. Let's not have this vlog moment. Let's not go into my mindset. Who gives a shit? Let's watch Better Call Saul. This is Bad Choice Road. I'm making them. I'm a fucking... I could direct traffic out there. Okay, I don't know what this intro is going to end up being in length, but right now I've been recording for almost 6 minutes, so just know I'm a mess. This is probably going to be a mess. What are you doing here? But it's your choice. Whatever. So... here we go, Better Call Saul, Season 5, Episode 9, Bad Choice Road. Here we go. Bad Choice Road, it is 59 minutes 38 seconds in length. Long one, I'm kind of scared. That's what she said. Shut the fuck up. We're pressing play in 3, 2, 1, play. Split screen. M her. Got it. Or Kim and Jerk, or Angel and Dumbass. Hydration, Comfort, the Goldfish, Desert, Danger, Snake. This is so clever. I mean, split screen isn't new, but they're mirroring not only their routine, but contrasting it with what...
Jimmy?
Yeah. It's me.
I'm okay.
Burnt face, piss chapped lips fly on the face. That cascade that came over her. Why is it getting to me later, a few seconds later? What's this delay? What's happening? Ah, with the Gatorade, amen. I'm writing myself a note, because I forgot to say something on the intro. I'll say it on the outro. Land of Enchantment. These colors ain't running. This is like in Pulp Fiction when they had to get the change of clothes.
Perfect. Perfect. We couldn't have planned this better.
If you saw those two, what would you think their relationship was?
Bodies, trucks, it's all still there.
Couple of flatbeds headed their way. They'll clear it all out like it never happened.
And the one who followed you? We'll be damn lucky if we ever find that guy.
Yeah, did the guy crawl away from the car? Did Mike go to clear it and then he wasn't there? Or, like, I think I cut it out and I don't remember.
De Guzman, Jorge.
$7 million?
I'm fine.
Does Lalo have any tattoos or any markings? Anything that could be affiliated with the gangs, the cartel? Because then even with his fake identity, they might be like, I don't know about that.
And now, Mr. De Guzman?
Damn. Damn, just like that. Is that discharge paper?
You must have a story.
Car trouble. Yeah. Mm. Broke down about 6 miles from the pickup site.
Car trouble.
Mm. Yeah. That's what happens when it's shot.
I walked north. Probably not the smartest move, but after a night lost in the desert, I made it.
So make sure you buy something nice for the wife. Man, she's a looker, huh?
Oh.
Fuck. What?
Respect, you know?
Slanging that dick. Yeah. So, what is he gonna tell her?
Oh, God, Jimmy.
What is this, cream of wheat?
Oatmeal. It's an oatmeal bath, anti-inflammatory.
That day or two out there would be fucking hard on him. Just some office person thrown out there.
You saw Lalo?
Yeah.
Usually it's her confronting him. Jimmy, this is weird.
I'm in the game, you're not in the game.
What? The game?
I didn't think I was gonna make it. I thought I was done.
Yeah, she has no idea about the cartel shit and the standoff. Isn't she gonna wonder where his car is and the mug is shot?
Okay. I won't see Lalo again.
Good.
Hopefully. Lalo might see her though. Like in Game of Thrones, when did you last see me? When did you last see me, or when did I last see you?
After all this, was it worth it?
100,000, bitch.
Go look in the bag.
Fuck! Oh, no! Oh, I didn't... I thought it would maybe an end-of-the-episode cliffhanger. This is happening so early in the episode.
Yeah, Jimmy.
She's gonna keep it to herself.
I see it.
Build up her fucking case and then hit him with it all at once. God, I felt all right. Now my head hurts. This is so bad. I feel like that scene in The Expanse.
I'll help you. No one will ever know it was ever here. It'll be our little secret.
You didn't have to.
My guess is they followed the Salamanca cousins up from Chihuahua, but they had tattoos. Same symbol I saw on a job back east, the Colombian gang.
Fucking two triangles, bitch. I don't know why I'm saying bitch so much. I miss Jesse. Fucking Spider-Man eyes.
These men were hired.
By who?
By who? And it cuts to Bolsa, right? That's his name.
Which good news is that? Colleague has been released by the American authorities at a substantial price, but he's free. Yes, I believe the coming weeks will be our best yet.
I see fillings in his mouth now. I wonder
Thank you.
If we ever noticed Enjoy fillings before.
He was trying to protect his own business by protecting our business.
If that's him trying to help.
He knows nothing of what we are trying to accomplish.
That at least you know the cartel doesn't know what you're doing here on the side, because otherwise they wouldn't have done that.
Nacho Varga. He wants out. He's done everything we ask. He's the only guy they have running things up here. He disappears, Salamanca operation falls apart.
They have more territory then. Yeah, that's a good way to spin it.
You have a gun to his father's head. That doesn't sit with me.
A dog who bites every owner he's had can only be disciplined with a firm hand or put down.
He had a dollar on the wall, kind of like Eyebrows did from the car wash. I think that's funny.
After that, I drive him south. He didn't tell me where. All I know is I'm dropping him off and somebody else is taking him over the border.
That it?
Yeah.
Hey. Hungry?
She should have just had the mug on the counter.
Probably the safest thing.
Yes, he's been deceptive, okay. But now she's...
I'll get it.
No.
She's also being deceptive, but...
Relax.
This is like when Walter would do shitty things, but then, like, I wouldn't want Skylar to retaliate, or I didn't like how she reacted. It's like, well, you know, you wouldn't be in the situation without some asshole kicking the stone, you know?
Well, I already called in sick, so you're stuck with me.
All the shots.
Damn it.
Shit.
Just doing a good job of not letting that mug get to her. Thinking about the fact he was almost shot in the face. The blood from the dude splattered on him. Audio jump scares are not fair. That's cheating.
Are you... Just wait 45 minutes. I can be there.
Jimmy.
Yeah, you tell them I'm on my way. They're trying to kill his plea deal because his buddy was carrying weed. I wouldn't feel right leaving him hanging.
I don't know if I believe him.
And I know something terrible happened in the desert. This isn't about our deal. I'm not insisting or forcing you to tell me. I just... No judgments.
Anytime a woman says no judgment, you're gonna get judged, my guy. Don't lie, Jimmy.
I had to drink my own pee. I was out of water, and in order to survive, I had to drink pee. And I'm gonna go get changed.
This is like Walter lying to Skyler. Like, do you know who called? And she just looks at him like, doesn't matter. She knows he's lying.
Into the minimum required rear setback. Minimum. Rich, are you free to talk?
Yeah, is everything okay?
Do not talk to him about Jimmy and Lalo in the desert. Is she leaving the company? That can't be it. She wants to do her bono work, or...
Also, it's no rush, but box up my diplomas and photos, please.
Are we moving offices?
I don't want you to worry. I talked to Rich. You'll be reassigned to another partner.
So with Jimmy making the money, she's gonna do her bono work? Is this for real? Saffron app. Doesn't Tuco get him a place out in the desert?
Todavía quedan muchas jugadas para hacer en contra de Frank. Además, estando en casa, voy a tener el oído de Ladio. Todo lo que sea de Frank va a ser nuestro. La familia es todo.
That's what he said to the cousins.
La familia es todo.
Where to?
Go. The border.
Casa Tranquilla. Actually, it was a single L, so it wouldn't be Tranquilla. It would be Tranquilla. Has to be double L to get the Y sound, right?
Hey! That was something. What happened in there? Hey, look, don't feel bad. You can't win them all. That one? Sheesh.
Is he like skinny with a pot belly? I know he eats a lot of shit, or is it just his posture? Really weird.
Hey, just so you know, I don't think any less of you.
Scene out of Alien 3, isn't it?
When will this be over for me?
You're gonna realize you haven't thought about it. You realize you can forget.
Lalo killed that guy. And for what? He killed that guy, and we're helping him.
Is he having a crisis of conscience? Jimmy has a soul?
We all make our choices. And those choices, they put us on a road. Sometimes those choices seem small, but they put you on the road.
He's foretelling his own future in Breaking Bad.
Like over a billion people on this planet. The only person I have to talk about this to is you.
Don't be pissy. He gave it to you straight up and honest. Skateboarder is taking a hit. Nope. So that's insinuating that something's going to happen to Lalo, but Nacho's with him. We don't see either of the characters in the future.
You want me to wait?
Nah. They'll be here. Really. Go. Look, I'll be in touch, man. Hey, that fire you did at Frings? That was good work, man.
Just out in the open. Is Mike gonna get a bead on him?
Take me back up the road. Slow.
What? Did he see something? I mean, Fring had a sixth sense about traps, but that's only because he realized that somebody had tricked Jesse into baiting Gus out, which is why he didn't trust the car in the parking lot. No way! no fucking way that he's just gonna see the esteem down there. Shatter your shins, fucking pop your Achilles, break an ankle. Or maybe he didn't trust Saul that something... He didn't trust Jimmy that he just got lost in the desert. Bad choice road. So many bad choices. And we're not done yet! What?
Yeah, what time is it?
It's 6:30. I have news, but it can wait.
Dipped out of the firm, man. Wasn't she a partner, too? What the fuck?
I, quit. Schweikart and Coakley. How about we get some food together?
Is she not mad that he's doing all this shit and got shot at? Is she trying to be about the life?
I keep pushing Mesa Verde away to do my pro bono work, and then when you were gone, I didn't know what happened. I mean, I thought you were dead. Then I spent the afternoon at the courthouse with pro bono clients without Mesa Verde hanging over my head. Best afternoon I've had in a long time.
Right, pro bono.
It's up, it's good.
Pro bono means no money. So what's the plan here?
I don't know, but I'll figure it out.
You just keep doing your friend of the cartel thing and...
Look, we all make choices, right? And those choices, they put us on a road.
Jimmy, he's trying to give her the mic conversation.
This is a bad choice road.
Yeah, so he can do what he wants, but she can't do what she wants. That's what I'm getting out of this.
When you decided to be Saul Goodman, I didn't get it. Still don't, really, but I stood by your decision. And I'm not changing my identity, I'm just leaving a job.
And what I did was completely different.
This is really none of your damn business.
Listen to me.
Get down.
Put your phone down, leave it on, so I can hear.
Who's at the door? Who the fuck is at his door?
Jimmy.
Hey, guys. I come in?
Oh, man. This is not something I expected.
Had some business to attend.
I should have after he found the fucking car.
Told you he'd be back.
You want to talk, we can talk. But Kim was just stepping out, so...
Nah, she could stay. Sit down, we're just going to talk. Come on.
You wouldn't need the gun then, as a show of force. Especially if it's just these two.
Tell me what happened.
What really happened?
What happened? I picked up the money from your cousins. My car crapped out. I delivered the money, and I saw you.
Tell me again.
If he does something, I think he's just gonna fucking do it. I don't know if he's gonna be slow or threatening, or if he's just gonna fucking do something.
Lala, this is exactly what he told me, so if you could just...
Tell me again.
Two heavy bags that you paid me to get. I put them in the trunk of my car.
If he reaches for his waistband, Mike's gonna take the shot.
I walked and I walked and I walked and I finally made it to a truck stop. And I bought a giant pack of energy drinks.
He's just giving him more details about the shit.
I saw your car.
Okay.
You push it in a ditch?
Are you kidding me with this?
Kim,
Do you know what he did for you?
Kim!
$7 million of your money. And he got you out of jail for a murder that, let's face it, you're definitely guilty of.
Kim, you shouldn't be... Now he's squaring off on her.
What exactly is it that you're getting at? What do you want?
I found his car in a ravine. Bullet holes on the side. I'm just waiting to hear how that happened.
Some kids found an abandoned car, broke down.
You don't think it's possible a couple of yahoos with guns shot up a piece of junk car and then rolled it down in a ditch?
End of story?
Kim.
If you don't trust your men with your money, you have bigger problems than if you trust Saul Goodman.
Well, sliver of truth in there.
He's telling you the truth.
But she knows
time you have a bunch
the
of
mug
money
has
and
bullet
no one
holes
you can
in
trust,
it.
A shell company or you've heard of the Cayman Islands, right? Jesus, get your shit together.
He's gonna offer her a job if he's impressed and offended and... He's fierce. you should reach up and grab her shoulders and remove her from, back her up. Fuck just happened. Yeah, now the fear, now all that's gonna fucking shake out. He's not south of the border, though. Gus doesn't want him dead up here.
What now?
Mexico. Come on, Ignacio, go. We got a long way ahead of us.
This dude is ground pounding for Lalo and for Gus. Just all the time. Work, work, work. That was a wild-ass episode. It could have gone south in so many different ways. Alright, to the outro we go. Season 5, Episode 9, Bad Choice Road. A shaken Jimmy spins up a story to explain his long absence, but the threads soon begin to unravel. Meanwhile, Kim finds herself at a turning point. Okay. So that was the episode. It's one of those episodes where the last 10 or 15 minutes has me, like, forgetting most of what happened prior. So the note I made earlier was to remind myself here that on last episode, the commentary, you know, the reaction type stuff was kind of weird because I didn't really say a lot in that whole episode. So most of what I said was predictions or survival shit or... So I had to keep that stuff in because that was the only editing points I really had, because everything else I said was just a lot of babble, a lot of, like, offshoot tangential shit that had no bearing or place in the episode. So it wasn't that I was trying to edit myself to look like I was tuned into the universe. It's that I didn't have other things to mix in there. But yeah, in regards to this episode, I'm especially surprised that the mug didn't wait longer until, like, I thought he was going to replace it or spin a story and then maybe she'd find it. But she found it in the bag right away and then kept that close. So then at the end of the episode, when fucking Lalo shows up and talks about the bullet holes, she knows that he's telling, she knows that, you know, what Lalo is coming at, something happened, but she still, like, ride or dies for Jimmy, and is just talking shit, but in Lalo's face, so to speak, like, you gotta trust your own guys, you don't trust them, you got bigger problems, the Cayman Islands, hello, like, she's trying to school him on how to criminal. Like, I don't have a lot of thoughts on this episode, but I have a lot of feelings, and it's just trying to figure out those damn things. And Lalo doesn't know that Mike was with Saul yet in the desert, so, because, like, everyone deals with Mike. Yeah, really, Mike deals and dealt with Gus and all his people, Saul, cop stuff, the DEA, like, he's got, like, involved with everything. As Saul likes to say, he knows a guy who knows a guy. That first guy is Mike, and Mike knows a guy, every guy. All right, I'm going to go ahead and stop this here. I've got to get to editing The Witcher and the second episode of The Wire. Holy shit, has there been different reactions to both of those shows? But this is going to do it for me for now. Thank you all so much for being here. I'm looking forward to the season 5 finale. Yikes, and I'm probably going to watch it before this comes out. So thanks again for being here, and goodbye.